really should. And, because, you know, I've made my living in the past, very successful living, by the way. I need good money. All right? And I admit it. You know? Because I've been very good at creating new companies and turning around companies.
Are you intimidated in any way by the workers' action? Because I think this morning they were calling on the Prime Minister to revoke their appointment of the management of TSTT. Are you intimidated in any way?
Well, okay, let me tell you this, right? You know, you all know I'm a pilot. I have my own private plane, and I can fly anytime. But that is not going to happen. Okay? And by the way, I bought my plane a long time before I came here. All right? And that is not going to happen. But let me tell you, there are employees here that are intimidated. This mob action is an intimidation to employees. It makes them feel like they have to go along. You know? Violence is not just what happens when you go out in the streets. Violence is when you threaten people.
The decision to call out the tactical squad, where did that come from?
Actually, it came from the police. You know, once they were all the way inside, you know, they were out here in the seventh floor, creating all the fuss. You know, our security forces said, hey, you know, we need more help.
Yeah. In terms of your infrastructure and installation, because of what happened yesterday, have you sourced additional resources to ensure that communications aren't disrupted?
Well, you know, the typical situation that I have put in the past is when you go through the 5-year cycle, and so many communications get disturbed and so on. We have done a lot in the last years in terms of creating redundancy, etc. And as you know, how many of you remember, there was a threat that the SOA was going to be disrupted. And it worked. It worked. The SOA worked in the communications. And in fact, you know, I have a lot of friends in telecommunications from all the countries I work in. And they said to me, wow, that was one of the best telecommunications situations that we've ever had. And I'm talking about people from Argentina. They haven't had it in Argentina all the best.
So, Joseph Kennedy said that he was looking at resolving the situation by July the 31st. Are you prepared to put by that date?
You know, and one of the things they keep doing is putting these dates. You will do it by such and such a date. You know? You don't dictate the date, you do not dictate the negotiation. And particularly, you do not dictate when it's important. So what is he going to do? Go to the court and say, you will resolve it by July 31st? I don't like it to be in court any more than they do. You know? But I will remind you that we actually went, we actually had a session by the court in which one of the things you do is you're not supposed to say what's happening internally. You know? What do you call that? Conciliation process, right? As you can tell, I'm not an expert in union relations. You know? We had this conciliation. During the conciliation, you're supposed not to say a word. You're supposed to just do the conciliation. They were with you all the time, right? We didn't say a word. We want to maintain our professionalism. And in the conciliation, you know, we didn't want to say it. You know what? There's a saying, it takes two to tango.
Oh, you're a trick.
Argentina. We think it will be at the same time, eventually, you will be able to go to the court.
I don't know whether you'll be a benefit or a disadvantage. I understand that the court in this country is very positive towards labor. But I also understand that they're fair. So at this point, the question is, you know, if you get two parties, you try to engage, and you keep giving and giving and giving and giving, and they keep saying no, 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 no. At some point, you have to say okay. Let a third party decide.
So the position that you offered the last time, that's the final position by the company.
It is.
Has there been any communication between yourself and the landlords?
No communication between myself and the line distributors. As you may recall, this is a joint venture. 51% owned by Nell, 49% owned by Capital Wireless in the UK. So I work for a board. I have a lot of communication with the board. And the board is, by the way, very concerned about this as well. In fact, we have a board meeting next week in London. And you don't have to report on this.
Well, earlier on you mentioned some of the workers may not be working here any longer, that will be looked at seriously.
Yes.
What sort of action do you intend to take against those workers?